here it comes.
Still coming.
Here it comes. It's interesting, even in there and in the trough, it advances, infiltrates.
Sure.
Infiltrates. Yeah.
I don't think I'm going to have to goose it anymore.
No, I don't think you do either. It's about to come over.
At this point, Roger, it's like a gravity current. You've got, the surface tension effects and all that are important.
Has it made it yet?
It has, and it stopped because it stopped right at the lip.
Yes.
There it goes.
Stop.
We may have to increase the rate a little bit.
Let's turn it up a little bit.
It's actually this pebble is underwater. But
we won't have any confetti.
That looks good.
This time.
But it looks like there's enough to be in the pot for him to be able to fall apart.
Hey, Jar, has Dick cut the notch yet?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Oh,
got it about 1 minute ago.
Okay.
Oh, you mean just junk on the water surface?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The water movement.
Right. Eventually.
So I'm wondering if no contact with ladder. Hey Roger,
this morning. Yes. Oh. Sorry.
And also this little wiggle thing too. So mm-hmm. Don't touch that.
And this is a really good when it really starts going lost, it's the advantage point.
Yes.
So I've always started my timer once I know that Dick is not gonna cut again.
Okay.
So
and have you started it now or
I
don't
know. Yeah, it's in there. I just was letting you know.
Right.
And I wrote that down in the book.
Yeah, we're gonna try to avoid any manipulation this time.
I don't know if it determines how far it advances.
It's definitely making headway. Yesterday we had to do rotation here in this phase.
Well, we'll see how reproducible this is.
What inflow is Dave supplying?
Dave, what's roughly your flow rate?
About 3.
About 3?
Yes.
Yesterday we were at more like 4.
That's gallons per minute?
Gallons per minute. So, I suppose we could turn it up to 4. See if you can ease it up. Ease it up to 4.
Okay.
I mean, if you were to compute what that does to the stage, it's some microscopic.
Oh, sure. But what's going on here is sort of microscopic.
Yes.
Fortunately, it doesn't smell.
It does help, you know.
It's nice to do the same thing. Yeah. It's the same focus.
Nice being in your apartment, huh?
Yeah.
Stupidly rough.
The confetti plug on the channel.
Yeah.
Different.
You know, and I think it's, the confetti is really, I think the magic, let's put it, skim it off, it's a good idea. Once it finally fails, it's really ripping.
Even, once it has a reasonable channel, it's not going to be confetti, doesn't it?
What's actually even?
Have you seen that video on YouTube of the guy filming on the slide and not the train?
Flow has a certain speed.
It's on YouTube. It's sort of slide turning. He's sitting in his car. Plus it makes a real big difference whether it's flowing over the wet sand or the train. It's the air. It's the right. This part of it is fascinating. I don't think it's terribly important, but it is fascinating.
Yeah, this thing.
It may help you understand the trick.
Roger, I think you need to spend at least a year working on an numerical model to reproduce the construction of this belt.
More in terms of timing, I think it'd be instructive to have Don to just cut a slot in this model and see how fast it takes.
Well, he told me that it's not particularly feasible. Or I may be misunderstanding that, but repeated adjustments to look at breaching is apparently not
feasible. I think that's not feasible. You could put in just one cut.
I suppose.
See how it responds to that.
Starting from a condition, which you could see.
The discharge is definitely increasing.
Very
slow rate.
Yeah, so if that exceeded the amount coming in, eventually the stop.
I'm absolutely certain that if we were to turn off the water,
it would stabilize the level itself. Would just drop and stop.
Yeah, at this stage.
Did you want to try that or not?
We decided we're not going to monkey with that. We're going for reproducibility. And right now we're pretty close to exactly what we were doing yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
It'd be interesting, you've got these things in terms of the timing down to the calibrated to run it just side by side in parallel pictures. Try and get the same and just watch it develop.
Matt has the technology to do that.
I don't know why you would want to try to reproduce anything, Dick. That's not how nature works.
That's right. A semi-periodic oscillatory process, where you get sort of a wave of water that comes in and boom, it all infiltrates, and the next wave will come in.
Well, I think it depends on the saturation levels.
Yeah. Interesting that the longitudinal profile of that delta is convex, as opposed to a classic one, the Lulu fan that's concave.
What was that?
The longitudinal profile of that delta is convex, as opposed to concave.
Right.
There's a one big rock in there that's kind of playing a role right now, but it'll eventually hit you.
Yeah, I don't think stuff like that has that much effect. It's just a road to see around.
Well, we got a few pebbles in there.
That's actually, so those for the chaos guys, that would be an estimate to them. They go, obviously throw a whole thing like that. It affects the whole thing.
It changes everything.
Yeah.
The butterfly.
No, it doesn't. It's really robust.
Sediment first starts to move is maybe, 20 centimeters down from the inlet.
Yeah, that's the way it looks. And it's sort of right before the flow. Well, it's kind of right where the flow, I think, starts to go critical.
Right. It starts to move. Seemingly, they're very close.
I mean, that seems like a complete coincidence. I don't know why.
Well, although the acceleration, associated with going critical, it might be just the acceleration needed to move the sediment. So maybe there is a cause and effect.
So if we started tracking particles down the channel, tracking the velocity, and it's like if you watch that line.
Should we throw in a few?
Yeah, and I think at this point we could do some hand feeding of confetti. Just don't do too many to clog the channel. There you go, there's a good one. I mean, more just like that single piece.
That single piece that is down, just support itself.
You can sort of see where they really accelerate.
Yeah. Yeah, it's right. It's right. And the waves tell you where it's going. It's true. It's good. Look, the infiltration. Just watch it.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Does it go critical?
Yeah. Oh, like 20, 10 or 20 centimeters down slope
right
where the mouths are.
Yeah.
And it appears that's kind of, it's at about the same place where it really starts to move bed load.
Yeah.
Yeah, at this point, the limit of bed load, you can see grains moving because of the color contrast. It's getting closer to the inlet.
So that the surface wave, the waves on the surface are a really good indicator of the onset of stability.
The toe here is also starting to leak water.
Just kind of like yesterday.
Does the sand slope look flat right where it goes critical, do you think?
You mean the bed slope?
Yeah.
No, I don't think it's flat. I think it's sloping.
Okay. No. In fact, there's a dune that's developed right kind of the middle of the channel. It's being fed. It's very right where that little rock is. Just to
toss
there.
A few more confetti.
We're going to be close. Almost.
Yeah, pretty soon it's going to be rock and roll time.
Yeah. As we get.
Kathy better get here in the next 2 minutes.
Just keep the waters on the same.
Yeah. Okay, I think at this point we'll just let it be until we're right near the end.
So here's our critical head cut, right there.
Right. So start dosing it more.
this is it.
Yeah, at what point do you want me to start collecting?
Yeah, we could do it. I mean, it's pretty much slurry-like, but we can go ahead and start doing it
right now.
Sure. Yeah. But we don't have to do it boom, boom, boom. It's like... wait until that roof is down.
Doing that hydraulic jump with that critical works its way up, then everything is off. Cuts the roof.
This is off.
Like right now. Right now.
Why don't we...
the trigger was way back here.
I mean, that could just be coincidence.
It could be.
Alright, that is
13, 14, 18. But they all got the same base
value.
That went all the way to the wall.
Yeah,
right?
First time I've ever had one that actually went all the way to the wall.
Yeah, as far as I know. Huh.